Hey there, this is Sam from Other Side Gaming, and welcome back to Respect Your Elders. Seeing as it's Halloween, I don't see why we just don't continue the nightmare that I started. Well, not started, but... anyways, today we're going to be looking at Resident Evil for the Dreamcast, I guess, because...
because it's the Dreamcast.
With that, how about we delve into this nightmare with a very deep and very dark sleep.
Believe it or not, Resident Evil 2 has quite the interesting history. After the roaring success of Resident Evil, Capcom began immediately on creating a sequel. One idea brought to the board was about two new characters who would find themselves fighting against plant-like creatures in the rubble of the Spencer Mansion. You know, the one that blew up at the end of the first game. Not much is known about the concept except for the name, Resident Evil Dash. However, some of these ideas would not go unnoticed, as some of them made the cut into Resident Evil 2. In July of 1996, people saw the first glimpse of Resident Evil 2 at the V-Jump Festival in Japan. This build of the game differed dramatically compared to the final version. This version of the game has become to be known as Resident Evil 1.5. In the build, players could take control of Leon S. Kennedy, a Raccoon City police officer, and Elsa Walker, a motorcycle enthusiast. The player was put inside a modern-looking Raccoon City police department filled with tons of zombies, even more so than the final game. During development, Shinji Mikami noted the game was too similar to the first, and even going as far to say that the gameplay and locations were dull and boring. After almost completing the game, the team was asked to go back to the drawing board and start over. That would be the end of Resident Evil 1.5, or so Capcom thought. A fan project was created to resurrect Resident Evil 1.5, and while it's not an official Resident Evil 1.5, it's still pretty fun to play. On January 21st, 1998, Resident Evil 2 was released in North America for the Sony PlayStation.
I'll be playing the Dreamcast version of the game, but essentially all the ports are relatively the same compared to today's standards, with a few or less features. However, it is popular opinion that the Dreamcast, GameCube, and PSN ports are the better.
I think the coolest part about the Dreamcast port is that the VMU shows your stats on the screen. But anyways, Resident Evil 2 picks up 2 months after the first Resident Evil. After the events at the Spencer Mansion, Chris and Jill try to compile a case against Umbrella Corporation for illegal experimentation. However, with all of the evidence up in smoke, literally, Chris finds other means to gather evidence while Jill remains in Raccoon City. During this time, an infection of the G-Virus, a new strain of the T-Virus, is sent through the populace of Raccoon City in the form of a skin disease. Eventually, the virus turns almost the whole city into the Walking Dead. Without any prior knowledge to what has happened, the player takes the role of Leon, or Claire Redfield, Chris's sister. You might ask yourself, wait, what happened to Elsa Walker? In essence, Elsa Walker was transformed into Claire Redfield to give the game closer ties to the first. The only ties to these two characters is their love of motorcycles. After Leon and Claire meet each other in the city, they are then separated by an out-of-control semi-truck. And so the nightmare begins. Gameplay more or less was the same as Resident Evil, tank controls and all. Yet again, I've never had any problem with this control scheme, but I'm also aware that a lot of people hate it. I think you should probably know that Resident Evil's 1 through 3 may not be your cup of tea if you hate these kind of controls. Depending on what disc you put in the Dreamcast, or your console of choosing, first, you will play as either Claire or Leon. As a side note, there are a total of 4 different endings in Resident Evil 2, and it all depends on which character you play as first. If you would like to play the official story, you will have to play the game as Claire first, and then as Leon. A lot of people were misdirected with the story because Disc 1 is Leon's side, and Disc 2 is Claire's side. So without even knowing, a lot of people plopped in Disc 1 thinking that the scenario they were planning was canon. Each character has a companion character as well. While playing as Leon, you will encounter Ada Wong, a woman who is looking for her boyfriend John, who just so happens to be a researcher at Umbrella Corporation, while Claire discovers Sherry Birkin, the daughter of William Birkin, who created the G-Virus. In both sides, you will have a chance to play as both of these characters in a few puzzle sequences. A majority of Resident Evil 2 takes place inside the Raccoon City Police Department. Because of the chief of police's taste for expensive items, the police department feels more like a mansion than anything. And that's not a bad thing at all. Hell, even some of the rooms in the police department look almost identical to the same rooms in the Spencer Mansion. It's creepy, but in a good way. Every room and item has extreme detail, and every door holds a new surprise. Speaking of which, Capcom even trolled a little bit with the door transitions at one point. Instead of being greeted by a new room, zombies rushed into the building. Nice touch, Capcom. The police department is just as confusing as the Spencer Mansion, and maybe even a little bit more. However, by the end of the game, you should have a mental map of the entire game. The halls of the police department hold much more than zombies and puzzles. Throughout the game, you'll encounter infected dogs, giant spiders, and lickers, a creature more deadly than the hunter, with its razor-sharp tongue. Zombies are littered throughout the rooms, but with a well-placed, somewhat tricky headshot, they don't pose much of a threat at all. The bigger enemies in the game are the ones you need to worry about. This category includes a G-Virus infected William Birkin, who you fight multiple forms of, and a T-1000 that chases you throughout Scenario 2. With winding corridors and vicious enemies, how do you plan to survive? Will you preserve your ammo and run away? Or will you take the risk to kill the infected? Either way, it will be difficult to make it out alive. No, seriously, if you're not prepared, this game is going to kill you. If you can overcome that difficulty, you can unlock all sorts of goodies like new costumes and new modes. These fun little extras actually make the game worth playing more than once, as well as the alternative scenarios and endings. Resident Evil 2 is filled to the brim with content, and it never gets old. Resident Evil 2 has some of the best graphics that I've seen for its time. Much like the first game, the game used pre-rendered backgrounds for the environment and 3D character models to fill the room. Because of the detail that can be made in the backgrounds, it ends up looking more realistic. Throughout Resident Evil 2, there are many sounds and tracks that play from intense to suspenseful. Yet again, I feel like the nail was hit right on the head. The music sets a wonderful tone throughout, and even the lack thereof sets me on the edge of my seat. The game's voice acting is also wonderful. Unlike the last game, there aren't any quirky lines due to translation.
That was too close. You were almost a Jill sandwich.
You're right.
But that doesn't necessarily save it from being a tad bit cheesy.
Sorry about that. When I saw the uniform, I thought you were another zombie.
Who are you?
The actors' performances are outstanding, nonetheless. With all of these things in mind, Resident Evil 2 comes with a highly regarded title as the best game in the series, and one of the best games of all time, in my opinion. There are many ways to play Resident Evil 2. There are so many ports it's hard to keep track of them all, but please, do me a favor, do not, I repeat, do not play the Gamecom version. Please, it's dreadful. Just take my word for it.
Well, I hope you guys all enjoyed the review. Have a really good, happy, safe Halloween. I really don't want to hear any of you dying. If I do, my heart. That's what happens. Anyways, I will see you guys next time. Later.